Okay, so good afternoon. So let's start with this question. See, what does it mean? See, if we switch off, and this is something a common phenomena. Any vehicle which is propelled by any machine, moment you switch on the machine, the propelling force stops and resistive force keeps acting. And here they are taking force to be proportional to square of velocity. And in a shutdown, a velocity, initial velocity was V naught. Find the average velocity at any time t. Okay, this is what we need to find. So let's take it's like a general case, not only specific in this particular case here. What is given in this case, this information which is given, this is acceleration will be negative of and proportional to v square. This is expression given, and based on this we need to find average velocity. How do you feel this is, how would you find average velocity? To find average velocity, if acceleration is uniform, in that case only we can find velocity at the beginning of time interval and end of the time interval and take its mean. In this case, acceleration is not constant, so we cannot find out average velocity in that fashion. So what is the way? I think I'll just briefly write what is the way to find average velocity over a period of time interval. There are two ways we can find out average velocity. One thing we found out, when anything, if you have to find an average over a time interval, average over a particular time interval between time t1 and t2, something like this. That is, any quantity it is valid. So one way of finding something like this, t1 to t2 into vdt. What is the other way of finding average velocity? Since we are in the topic of kinematics, average velocity is also equal to displacement by time. So another way of finding would be, I can find displacement here, which is similar to here, but they are nothing very different. Displacement by time. So mentally what we think, okay, I need to find an expression of x as a function of time. If I find how much displacement takes place in time t, I can find out. So let's go about. So if we have to find displacement, we need to integrate it twice. That's all we need to do. So this is first time, this first integration. So at time t is equal to 0, we know what the velocity is, which is v naught. And let's assume at time t velocity is v, it is dv by v square minus k, this expression, sorry, this is equal to minus k. And on, if we integrate, we find the v terms come something like this. It is 1 by v. We get v is equal to v naught 1 plus kt. This expression we get here. And once we get this expression, we know we have to get x term here. So x term, this is nothing but dx by dt. So arrange and rearrange this term here, this expression, it becomes, so what we take, wherever it is at time t is equal to 0, that position I take as x equal to 0, at time t position is x. So this x gives you nothing but displacement in time interval t. Okay, so pretty clear. So we have to integrate it twice. So if I integrate again, I get an expression of x like this. This is a displacement, and we have some more expression here. So depending on how the options are given, after we find my average velocity is this expression by time. This is my average velocity, and I can, depending on how the options are given, we can write this term in different forms. What are different forms we can write? 1 by kt can be written as, this term can be written as v naught by v. That's one thing we can do, v naught by v. And even 1 by kt is equal to v naught by v. And even term t also can be written as, written in terms of v. So what is t? Whether t also can be written as 1 by k v naught by v minus 1. So depending on how options are given, you rearrange, you get your option. So this is basically pairs.
So if we use v dv by ds is equal to minus k v square.
Pardon me?
In the first step, we use dv by dt is equal to minus kt square, right?
Yes.
That will give us the velocity.
Yes.
And then in the same expression, if we use v dv by ds, we can get the displacements. That gives a simpler expression. We'll directly get the log expression. Right?
Okay, but tell me, okay, what we get v expression? We got v as a function of time. Okay.
Yes, sir. Again, in the first step, the first one, acceleration can also be written as v dv by ds, right?
Okay, I'm basically saying you can write expression as, okay. Another we can write as expression as v dv by dx. Okay, fine. I think we can write a v dv by dx is equal to, we can write minus k by v square, and we can find velocity. Fine, absolutely. We can find directly in that form also we can find. Okay, so we can find if velocity is not required, we can find at a displacement x. But in this case, are we getting t term here?
Sir, we know the velocity at t, right? V?
We don't know.
No, sir. We integrate using limits, right?
Basically, in that case also, we find the value of t. But basically, we need time expression also. We need displacement expression also. Both the things we need. Perhaps, yes, maybe this might be a little simpler. You can do that. We can have velocity. We can find velocity in terms of, velocity in terms of t. Again, you t also, we need to express in terms of, we can do that. Yes, we can. Perhaps it may take, but I think it may come very similar way. May not make too much of a difference because time also is required. Suppose this question was find average velocity over a distance x. Over a distance, first displacement x. I think this would have been even simpler. Then in that case, t is not required at all. Okay. Yes, basically, maybe this is simpler. You can find it. Yes, this may, some of all of you can try. Perhaps this may take, say, one step more. You can find it a little easier. No need for substitution. I think you can avoid the substitution in that case. Okay, coming back to this question, I think this question most of you have solved this question. How many have actually tried solving this question? We did one way of solving the question was we took as a horizontal projectile, and in using horizontal projectile, having taken this x and y coordinate. See, when it strikes, we assume that it hits the plane at time t. And this is something, see, when we calculate, you'll understand one more thing here. See, if you look at, if I take this as origin, and if I take this position vector, which is initially horizontally, position vector is constantly changing. So any particular angle, it will make a particular angle, position vector will make a particular angle only at one instance of time. There will be no two values. Every position vector, so as the angle keeps on increasing with time, every angle is made only a particular one instance. So this also, when it hits here, what does hitting this inclined plane mean? At the instance this particle hits this point on the inclined plane, the position vector with reference to point of projection will make an angle of negative 37 degree with respect to horizontal. Okay, so it strikes the plane. So we simply use this equation. This is the point it strikes the plane. And we can write those terms here. This is something, I think this is what we discussed. This is pretty easy if this is the term. So this will be y coordinate at time t. This will be x coordinate at time t. And y by x is equal to tan theta. And we can find time, and we can find x coordinate, and then you can find plane. Then we also said, can we find out using x axis along the surface, as in the case of user project? We take it along the surface, because this is what we typically do in case of normal projectile on horizontal surface. So this case also, the similar way, how we find range, we find out time of flight, and then we calculate displacement along x-axis during time of flight. So I hope most of you are done. 1D motion along x-axis. So we need to write, so whenever we need to write what is the initial velocity. This angle is 37, the initial velocity becomes u cos 37. And we need to take the component of acceleration. I think some of you might have little difficulty in taking components of acceleration. What is the direction of acceleration? Acceleration is g vertically downwards. This is the direction of acceleration. And we need to take its component along xy coordinate. And if this angle is theta, this angle will become 90 minus theta, and hence this angle also will be theta. So whatever angle the plane makes with the horizontal, so this angle also becomes 37 degrees. Once it's 37 degree, is cos 37 will be its component along y-axis, but that will be negative. And sine 37 is component along x-axis. Those who are a little difficult in components, I think you need to work on that. Ax becomes equal to g sine 37. And along the chosen direction, this is positive. And 1D motion in y-axis, uy is equal to u sine 37, this component. And acceleration is negative. Hence, that's why it will slow down and will come to rest and it will come back here. And what is the time of flight here? Time of flight is very simple. So whenever this kind of motion is there, it comes back to the same point after time, 2uy by ay. So from here also we can substitute. What will the time taken? Time taken we substitute 2uy by ay here. And what would the range be? Range is displacement along x-axis during time t. So we'll calculate and we take the t common, ut plus 1 by 2 at square. I've taken t out here. It is ux plus 1 by 2 ax into t. We substitute this value, we can find that expression. So this also another way we can solve. And I suggest all of you should do it once. If you want to prepare for in time plane projectile. So once we do for one or two questions, that's adequate. Now coming to the ball question, I guess again verified. I think this is, this number should be 4.5. And let me do it slightly different way. I think this is a more general way. Perhaps maybe this much better way to solve. What is the condition when the ball strikes the nth step? And actually, when the steps are, this is uniform, we can also solve this question just like an inclined plane. Let's see how do we solve just like inclined plane, and it takes care of all scenario. It need not nearly strike at the edge. Let's see carefully how do we solve this question. Then it hits the inclined. So let's imagine if I draw a line or plane running through, covering all the edges. The plane runs through like this. So if a particle, so we'll forget about steps for a while. We'll look at the inclined plane passing through edge of the surface. You know, just like that, you have put a ramp kind of thing on the steps. And if this is the first step, this is the second step, this is the third step, and this is the fourth step. So if the particle strikes this particular point on the inclined plane, it is going to strike the fourth step. If this strikes at this point, it's going to strike the fifth step. So we understand here. So this is something. So depending on, this is horizontal projectile, this is like inclined plane, which point it strikes at, if we can find out the point, we'll know which steps it will correspond to. So we have taken, we have converted into inclined plane problem. It hits inclined plane passing through edge of the step at time t. So let's see how we solve. So let's see at time t. So from here it goes, and it goes like a horizontal projectile. And at time t, it comes and hits at this particular point here. If it is this particular point, it has to satisfy certain condition. Since it has hit a particular inclined plane, there has to be particular relationship between x coordinate and y coordinate. So at this particular instance, it will have certain y coordinate, yt, which is displacement along y direction in time t, and it will also have some xt. And what is the relationship between xt and yt? We can find out value of t from that. So what is the condition we get here? So if this angle is theta here, and then theta, is y by x, and y by x tan theta will be depend on the nature of the steps here. If this angle is theta, the theta will be the height of the step and the length of the step. Height of the step is 20 centimeter, and the length of the tread, what we call, is 30 centimeter. So the tan theta, the angle made by a inclined slope, which is like a ramp passing through edges of the stairs, will be equal to this. 0.2 by 0.3 is y by x. And hence, this y coordinate and x coordinate also will have same relationship. Let's put this values. What is the y coordinate? 1 by 2 gt square and ut. And based on this, we can find value of t. Becomes equal to, we simplify, it becomes 4u by 3g. And if we substitute the value at 4.5 meter per second, t is equal to 0.6 second. It means from the moment it leaves the flow, after 0.6 second, it comes and strikes the surface. Now, which step will correspond to will depend on x coordinate. So what is the x coordinate at time t will tell me which step it is going to strike at. So can we calculate x here? X will be equal to u into t, becomes equal to 2.7 meter. So 2.7 meter, so if, since here length of each step is 30 centimeter, it exactly, if I divide 2.7 by 0.3, I get exact round number. We divide by this, I get 9. 9 means it strikes at the edge of the ninth step. If it was a round, not a round number, suppose it came as 2.9. 2.9, if I had divided by 0.3, it would have come 9 plus something. So whenever it comes something, so we have to take an integer next higher than this number. It would have been 10th step. So we can solve for, even if it is not striking the edge also, we can find that number. Pranav, is this understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So you can find any number also. So any such plane steps are involved, we can solve this question. And this is, I think, fairly straightforward to solve. Okay, next question. This question I also expect all of you to solve easily. Particle is projected perpendicularly from a long inclined plane as shown. So unlike previous case, it was horizontal projection. Perpendicularly means this angle is 90 degree. And find the range of projectile measured along the incline. So can we all get an answer for this? So I'll wait for a while. And so that we can appreciate when we start solving which method is suitable in which case here. Okay. It is horizontal. Okay. So this is case we take. So when it strikes the inclined plane, What will happen when we strike the incline? Suppose we do a similar case also. So it goes like this and it hits the incline. So we are using xy coordinate here. And can we find out what time it will hit the plane? Can we find the time? See, one important point is when it hits the plane, is x and y coordinate has to have a particular relationship. What is the relationship here? In this case also, if I have taken y direction upwards, just be careful. When it is y direction upwards, when I take tan theta, this y is negative. So tan theta, so tan, this angle is 37, but this is not plus 37. I'll write tan theta y coordinate by x coordinate has to be equal to minus 3 by 4. So y coordinate is negative. That's the only difference we have to be careful about. So that's the only reason I have taken this one here. So when I take y coordinate at time t divided by x coordinate at time t, here it should be minus 3 by 4 if I take upward direction with positive and is striking at a downward direction. And rest all is simple. So what will the y coordinate at time t? U I t minus 1 by 2 g t square. T is taken common out, so it is cancelled. So u by minus 1 by 2 g t by t if I substitute this value. So basically, if I can find the value of t, this is the time it will strike this point here. Moment I have found out the time, we know the value of x, and moment we know the x, we can find out the range also. So we can solve this way. And what is the other way of solving this question? Let's look at the other way of solving, choosing x axis along the surface, okay, as is the case in normal projectile. So in this case, we have chosen this as x axis, another one is a y axis. So 1D motion along x axis, what are the components? Ux is 0, velocity has no component. But acceleration, we should know. I think most of you may recall from laws of motion also, gravitational acceleration along the slope is g sin theta, theta being the inclination. Ax will be equal to g sin theta. Since downward direction is positive, acceleration is in that direction, it is positive value. And Ay is equal to minus g cos theta. This is negative. Acceleration is the negative direction. And u is the initial velocity. So in this case also pretty simple. What is the time of flight? Time of flight is 2y by y. So this is expression when you substitute. This is the time of flight. And what is the range here? Range is 1 by 2. Then we calculate displacement along x-axis during time of flight, which is equal to 1 by 2 x into t square. And we substitute this answer we get here. So all of you can solve. Just take a minute. See, all of you can do it yourself. Is that every part clear? Okay, I think who are the first one to solve this question? So this is a question here, and Vignesh, you are the first one to solve. Vignesh, can you tell how did you solve and what was your thought process?
Sir, first we, like there's no horizontal acceleration, so we can equate both the x components of velocities.
Okay.
So we get the velocity when it strikes b in terms of u, and then we find the y components, and then v is equal to u plus at.
Okay. So what you have done here, so basically what you have taken, okay. So you have taken, okay, so this is u, and it strikes the surface perpendicularly. If it strikes the surface perpendicularly, we get this angle also. So you are saying this particular place, this angle is 60 degree. And when it hits the plane here, this angle is 30 degree. Did you use this?
Yes, sir.
No, so u and v, and since horizontal component has to be equal, and by equating horizontal component, I can write u cos 60 is equal to v sine v cos 30. I can find the value of v in terms of u, and then
we find the y component.
Y component. Okay, that's the way you have solved. Okay, that's one way of solving the question. Good. Abhirup, how did you solve this question? So I hope all of you understood. It strikes the surface B perpendicularly mean when it hits the plane, the direction of velocity is perpendicular to the surface. And since the surface makes 60 degree, this angle is 60 degree. So with horizontal, make an angle of 30 degree. And if I want to extend this one, what does it mean here? Earlier it was making 60 degree plus, now it is making 30 degree minus. Actually, these two velocities are mutually perpendicular. These two velocities are mutually perpendicular. So that's one way, Vignesh. Now let's look at there are three different ways you can think of solving the question. Now, Abhirup, did you have same method or some other way?
The same way, sir.
Same way. Can you think of some other way also? Can we think of some other way? See, because one more thing you notice here, what is special about in this case? In this case, I think just I pointed out, the velocity, whatever direction velocity is u has, when it strikes the plane, it becomes perpendicular. At this particular instance, velocity is perpendicular to initial velocity. Is it not? Is it easy to spot that velocity is perpendicular? See, this makes 30 degree plus from horizontal. This makes down. So basically 90 degree. So this velocity is perpendicular. So how is the trajectory? Trajectory goes like this. So using the fact that they are mutually perpendicular, can you think of some other way of solving? Can anyone think of some other way of solving? Any very quick way of solving? Based on this information, Vignesh, can you think of some other way of solving? You understood what is happening here? These two are mutually perpendicular.
More like a circle.
No, not like a circle. Then these two velocities are mutually perpendicular. So can I, they are mutually perpendicular, and if I take this axis as x-axis, because it is fired from here, and this axis and y-axis. Okay. So in this case, what happened when V becomes perpendicular, basically what? It means at this instance, y component of velocity becomes zero. This is time of ascent with reference to this axis system. Is this understood by some of you? Tejas, what did I say? Have you followed what I said now? What we are saying now?
Yes, sir. When it reaches at that point, we get y coordinate is equal to zero. If you assume that
if I take this as x and y axis,
yes,
it is perpendicular, means initially it was along y axis, it will become parallel to
x axis. Yes, sir.
What is the advantage of that? Is that now can I find very quickly? So if I use this x and y axis, here the velocity, y component becomes zero. And how much time does it take for y component to become zero? It takes time taken. It is like time of ascent.
Yes, sir.
Uy by ay.
Ay.
What is ay in this case? Is it pretty simply known? What is ay here?
Yeah. Yes, sir.
How much is ay? Angular momentum is 30. G cos 30.
Yes.
So answer is u by g cos 30. Vignesh?
Yes, sir. Understood, sir.
Is it the same answer you're getting?
Yes, sir.
And so this same thing. We can solve. See, reason why we take up this question, not necessarily because this question is going to come. We take up a question, the different questions, we learn different ways of analyzing the question and different ways of solving the question. Okay. And similar question may also come. Same question can be worded. What is the time? Same question. If I write another question I have given in the worksheet, read that question. If this is a question, these two questions have the same answer. Think of a reason why they have same answer. If I ask a question, something like this. A particle is projected at an angle of 60 degree from the horizontal. Find the time t when the velocity will become perpendicular to velocity of projection. Do you think this question answer and this question answer are the same or different?
Like rotation of axis, right?
Yes, sir.
No, just look at this. Why these two give same? Definitely they are going to give you same answer. Why is that so? Is it the same thing happening? This also is a projection at an angle of 60 degree from horizontal. And this is a time when velocity becomes perpendicular to initial velocity of projection. And I have meant yesterday, the velocities, two velocity can become perpendicular only when angle of projection is greater than 45 degree. We have done something similar. So that way also we can think. I hope some of you are following. Okay.
Sir?
Yes.
But so the answer won't be same in this case, right, sir?
Like, yeah, it will be same. Now come to third method. One more thing. This is clear? This is very well understood?
Yes, sir.
Third way of solving. At this point, what is given here? Because suppose they were not perpendicular. At this point, velocity makes an angle of minus 30 degree. Is it not? Velocity vector. So what time we know velocity? Velocity can be written as a function of time. I can find the angle velocity makes at different points of time. So we need to find this question answer is what? It is t when the velocity vector makes an angle of minus 30. So tangent of minus 30 is equal to angle the velocity vector makes. And what is the velocity vector angle made by velocity vector? It is y component divided by x component. The fact, when does the angle become negative? When the velocity in y direction turns negative. So simply if I write this expression, just see that this is also understood. Tangent of minus 30 will be equal to Vy divided by Vx. What is Vy? Uy minus Gt divided by Ux. If I substitute this also, I get the same value of T. So there are 3-4 ways we can solve this question. Is this also understood? Jaideep, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Have you understood all ways of solving the question?
Yes, sir, understood.
Is this understood? Why this minus 30?
Yes, sir, because that's the angle the velocity vectors up.
Yes, what will happen if I have plus 30? What is happening is angle is constantly changing, reducing from 60, 59, 58, 57. Now, so if I have plus 30, it will give the time when the velocity makes plus 30 degree angle. After crossing the highest point, angle will turn negative because this term will come negative. GT will become greater than UY. So that's why you have to be careful with the sign. The reason I have taken up this question also, understand significance of sign. Is this also clear, Vinesh?
So here we take the x-axis only as the like the horizontal line as the x-axis.
Yeah, typical horizontal. This I have taken with the typical horizontal axis.
Yes,
sir. So all ways we can solve. There are 3-4 different ways and see that all are clearly understood. If you know multiple ways, we can always choose the one which is best. We have taken this one, I have taken xy axis, normal. So there are a number of ways I have solved, and each one I think this is something we can follow. Bhagyashree?
Yes, sir.
It is becoming more confusing or it gives you some better understanding?
It's understandable, sir.
Understandable. Like sometimes what happens, we have multiple ways, so our mind gets more confused. But multiple ways, I thought, gives you better clarity also. You understand different ways how things can be analyzed. All are clear to you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Lakshita?
Yes, sir.
All are clear?
Yes, sir.
Even this also you understood?
Yes, sir. Actually, I got the answer through the second method.
Okay. But then all are clear. So you can think of a little. See, once we, whatever in this question, what are 3-4 things I have discussed? If you understand all of them, basically you get a very good grip of projectile motion.
Yes.
Okay. We can do so. Number of ways we can solve. Or x-axis along this one. Okay. This question. Let's look at this, whether you can solve this question. So this question is for all of you. See, we can. So this is not the question, this question. So Vignesh, can you briefly explain how did you go about solving this question?
Yes, sir. So once the bullet enters the train, to reach any point which is 5 meters below it, it takes 1 second, right, sir?
Absolutely. The first thing, what important, first it is interest, diagonally opposite corner is here. So that this is the point where it means it to hit a diagonally opposite corner, it has to have a vertical displacement of 5 meters. That's the key point what you have to understand. Is it not? What is spotted?
Yes.
That vertical displacement in vertical direction, and that is because of gravity. And how much time does it take to have a displacement of 5 meters in 1 second? It will have a kind of path, and then so it will have path, it will be at this point. And actually by the time, okay, so this is something. So you have figured out it will take 1 second to hit that point. So first thing you figured out, to hit opposite corner, to strike opposite corner, delta y, but delta h, vertical displacement has to be equal to 5 meters. Vertical displacement has to be equal to height of the coach, which is equal to 5 meters. Hence, which tells me the time it takes is 1 second. Once we have 1 second, rest is easy. So this is something, it hits this point in 1 second. So actually what will happen, this particle will keep traveling in the same direction. It will come, it will take this path here. In 1 second, what has happened? So in 1 second, it has moved along this direction by distance of 3 meters. Because from this plane, along direction of motion, it has a distance traveled 3 meters. Vertically downward direction, it has traveled a distance of 5 meters. And during this period, the point on the coach which was here, this point on the coach has traveled a distance of 15 meters. That's what has happened. So it has undergone a vertically downward displacement of 5 meters, which takes 1 second. Forward direction, in original direction of motion, it has traveled a distance equal to displacement, the component of dimension of coach in the direction of motion. 3 meters it has traveled in 1 second. So this velocity used 3 meters per second. And since it has hit this point has moved from here to this point here, which is 15 meters. That's your V value. Okay, so some of you are good enough. We can easily spot that point. So that's what he had in this. And So tomorrow also, I will not start, maybe I'll see, either I'll start relative velocity or we'll take up some more examples on the topic of projectiles and then we go on to relative velocity. Okay.